Hey Titans, this is Mordecai from Gamer Titan, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to both create an account, download, and start using the Core platform. Now currently, at the time of filming this video, Core is currently in open alpha, so expect some changes as ManaCore, the company that owns Core, continuously develops the platform. I expect it only to get better, and already in open alpha, it's an awesome program. So first off, before we get started, you're probably wondering, what is Core? Now, Core is a platform that allows you to both create and publish your own games, as well as play other games that others have created. Now, this is pretty powerful because Core allows you to easily create multiplayer games. As an example, I've currently been using Core for about a week, and I was already able to quickly create a game, get it published, and share it, and be in a game with my friends, all within the span of about 2 hours of using the platform. Now, if you have never created a game before, but you are interested in doing so, then Core is definitely the platform for you. It allows you to create games with a drag and drop interface, and there's no coding required. However, if you do want to create something that's a bit more unique or a bit of your own functionality that isn't currently offered as a template, you will need to know a little bit of code, but Core uses Lua, which is a very simple language to learn and actually has use cases outside of the Core platform. So to download Core, the first thing you want to do is head over to coregames.com. You'll be presented with a page that looks like this, and you'll go ahead and click join for free. Now, what you'll need to do is go ahead and create an account. So they'll ask you for your email, your username, and your password. Now, one thing to note here is that your username will be tied to your Core account. And therefore, every game that you publish or any game that you are playing in, your username within that game will be whatever username you select here. So just be aware of that. Be sure to select something that you are comfortable with having across every game that you play and create within Core. After you've created an account on Core, they will send you an email. So be sure to go ahead and check on your email and confirm your link. And after you've done that, you'll then be logged in to Core. Now from here, you can browse games and stuff like that that are already currently on the Core platform and see, for example, we'll dive into this deeper, but like active games. So currently there's 8 people playing this game. There's 2 people playing this game. Now be aware that once again, Core is currently in open alpha. So while it's not that popular currently, I only expect this to grow because this platform is extremely powerful. And every single person that I've shown Core to thus far, I've had over like 20-25 people that I've showed this to, like gamer friends and family and stuff like that, and every single person was very excited to see Core. So what we'll want to do is you'll want to click on the top right here, or if we go back to where you will originally land when you actually log in, is go ahead and download Core. So click on the download Core now. And what this does is it's currently about 3.5 gigabytes on your hard drive. Their documentation says that it should go up to about 5 gigs eventually. And what you're downloading here is all of the assets that are able to be used in Core games. Now, what's very unique about Core is once you download all of these assets, so once you download the Core platform, when you want to play a game, no matter if you've played the game before, you don't have to download the game because you already have all of the assets that are required to play that game. And so you can quickly hop between games. So for example, I've shown like a few buddies that have downloaded the Core platform. We hopped between multiple games and tried out various creations that other creators have created. And it was pretty fun because to do that on other platforms requires you to sit there and download every single game. And you know, if you don't like that game, then you have to re-download the next game, etc. So once you get the Core platform, you will then want to open the launcher on your computer, and we'll go ahead and hop over to that. So once you've installed Core and opened the Core launcher and logged in, you will now be within the core launcher on your computer. And as you can see, it's pretty similar to the games menu on the website, but this allows us to play these games. So once you have core downloaded, if you do go to a website, if you do go to their website or someone shares a game link with you through the browser, you can click play and it'll automatically open up the core launcher and begin playing the game. But right within the core launcher, we can see it defaults us to which games are being played, and we can quickly just click on one of these games, and if I were to click play here, I would begin playing the game. Now, one thing that a lot of people that first get core are interested in doing is, one other thing that's unique about core is your characters. So your characters in core are the characters that you will be playing as throughout every game in core. There are a few exceptions to that, because in some games you can actually hide the character. And for example, if you're like playing a Marvel game or something like that, obviously you wouldn't want to be running around as this dead pirate that I have here. You would be a marble. However, the majority of games, you will be using these characters. And what's cool about core is it allows you to save up to 6 different character slots. And once you're in a game, by pressing on B, it brings up a menu that allows you to change between these characters right inside the game. And so if you want to select a character, what you'll want to do is, we'll go ahead and make a new one here. We'll go ahead and equip this one right here. So we just hover over whatever character we want. We click on equip, and it's saying that I need to overwrite a slot because I'm currently maxed out on my 6 character slots. So we'll go ahead and click yes. And as you can see, it added my new character to my favorites here. And what this allows me to do is go ahead and click on edit. And in edit, I can select various different things. So I can select a head, like which head I want, what I want to be wearing as like my upper clothes. So you can see I can switch between these, and same thing with lower and backpack. Now, another cool thing about core is it allows you to also customize the colors. So for example, say I wanted to customize the color of my armor here, I can click on this little color palette and I can change the color to my liking. Not every piece of armor currently allows colors, I believe. I think I found a few that don't, but for the majority of them, you can change various colors. You can also change the skin color of your character. So say that I wanted to not be wearing a helmet, I can click between these and change the color of my character. Now, the other thing that you can do is, if you would like, you can click the randomize button here and go ahead and see what the game spits out for you as a good starting point. Now, once you're happy with the character, you just go ahead and click on save. And as you can see, now I have this character in my favorite slot, which allows me, right now it's selected as my default, so this is what I'll go into the game as. Or if I want, I can press B once again and select between these 6 of my favorite characters. So the other thing that you're able to do in a lot of games is use a mount. So up here at the top, we have our different mounts. Very similar to characters, we can select which mounts we want, put them in our favorite mounts, and be able to change between our various mounts in game. Now, currently there's 5, but there is 6 slots. I expect there to be more character models and mounts in the future. And finally, we have an emotes page. So once again, just like the character and mounts page, we have 6 favorites, and we can go ahead and equip the various different emotes. Now, when you click equip, it will play an animation. I think if we click here without equipping, it just plays it, so we can go ahead and see what various emotes are available to us. So once you're happy with your various characters, the next menu item that we kind of already covered, but I just want to go ahead and finish that up, is clicking on games. Now we have our character, we can go ahead and click on whatever game we want to play. And when we click on the thumbnail of whatever game looks interesting to us, it brings us to the game summary page. And on the game summary page, very similar to a lot of other websites out there, we can see various reviews from other users. We can see when the game was published, when it was last updated, the max players that it allows, and total plays. And finally, if we wanted to play the game, we could click play here. Or if we wanted to go ahead and send this game to a buddy who could then hop in and play the game with us, we can click on the share button here, and it'll generate a shareable link that we can send to our friend who will then be asked to go ahead and play the game. So one of the most powerful features of Core, of course, is to be able to create your own games. So if we go ahead and click on the Create tab here, we can create a new game. And what's powerful about Core is it gives us a lot of different options. So for example, if we were pretty comfortable with what we wanted to build and we didn't need any boilerplate assets or code, we could go ahead and click on Start a New Project. Core also has frameworks available. So if we go ahead and click on frameworks, you can see that there's various different frameworks of different games that we may want to create. If we click back here and click Recreate, if we click on View Projects, the other thing that's powerful about Core is if you want, if you create something, you are able to share it with the community as an editable game, meaning that if I click on View Projects here, these are games that other creators have created, and I'm able to click on the game and in its current state, download this game and add it into Core and begin editing it from that game. So if there's a game that's similar to like what you're wanting to create, this is very helpful because you can download the project, kind of get a feel for how they did different things, and also get more familiar with, you know, where they place models, how they did various things. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and just create a quick project here out of a framework. We'll do a deathmatch. You'll want to name your project, so we'll just do Gamer Titan and click create. And as you can see here, now we have created a game. It started from our framework. So there's a few things here. There is the viewport right here, which allows us to, in real time, see how our game looks. And by holding the right click, we can zoom in and out. And by holding right click and clicking WASD, we can move around the map. Now this is just going to be a quick tutorial on just the basics of stuff. I'm going to have another video that deep dives into the creator tool and all the various different options to us, different tools and stuff like that. But as you can see, just very quickly, if I wanted to move something, so first let me go ahead and click preview by holding shift and clicking the equal sign. It'll start a preview. So this is from the template. As you can see, I'm the character that I selected earlier, and I'm in this game. It gives me some default assets, a default map, and I have a gun, a health bar, UI, everything, so I can shoot the gun and all that. So just to give a very quick demo on how easy this is to move stuff around and to create, say we wanted to, for whatever reason, move this in the air, I could just click on this actual object and drag it throughout the world wherever I wanted. So I moved it up there, and we'll go ahead and click play again. And as you can see, now that object is in space on my game. So as you can see, it's very easy to do very basic things, things that in other game engines are actually pretty hard. And just as one final demo here, because as you can see, it just the textures on this aren't looking that great. So we can go to materials, and these are all the various materials that we have available to us. Now there's a few other options that you can create custom materials and customize these materials to use in your game as well. But just as a quick example, say that I wanted to make this floating door blue, I would just drag this material onto it. And as you can see, it's now blue on this side. So we'd have to do the same on this side. And we will go back into the game, and it is a floating door that is blue. Now finally, say that we were happy with our game thus far and we wanted to go ahead and publish it and allow our friends to hop in and play with us. In the top right here, we go ahead and click on publish game. It's gonna tell us to save, which we will do. And it brings up a menu here that we just need to put in some information. So just type in demo game, release notes, V1.0, just add some tags. So we'll just do third person, and we'll need to add a screenshot. So we'll go ahead and take a screenshot. It brings up this camera here. Just click that and it adds the screenshot. So now what I could do is I could either publish this as public or I could set it to private. So what I recommend initially doing is setting your games to private. This will allow you to generate a link that you can share with your friends. So I click review and publish, and then click publish game. It publishes the game and it gives me a link. So now if I share this link with any other user that has Core, they can hop in this game and play with me that quickly. And that is the power of Core. So hope you liked this video. I'll definitely be doing a lot more in-depth tutorials. I just wanted to show a very quick demo of Core, what is available to us, and how quick and easy it is to use. So if you like this video, please thumbs up, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more Core content.